Okay, now we'll have a few words about inductive soundness. We know this is an inductive argument. For one reason, we have the word probably, slyly put in there right here by me in the last minute. Also, the conclusion's a prediction. Most times, if a conclusion's a prediction, you have good reason to believe it'll be inductive, because you just don't know things about the future with total certainty the way you would with deductive arguments. That isn't true all the time, but the word probably helps. Once we know it's an inductive argument, we'd want to ask, is it a strong or weak argument? I think in this case, we'd agree it's strong. That is, if the premise was true, the conclusion would have good reason, not certainty, but good reason to believe the conclusion. If it snowed for the past 10 years in Canada, that gives me good reason to believe it's going to snow next year. Not guaranteed, not certainty, but a good reason. That's where I bet my money. Better than 50% chance. Okay, well, once we figure out the logic's good, that is, it's a strong argument, but it doesn't make it a great argument. A lot of logically good arguments are still bad. We also want it to have true premises. So for the argument to be ultimately good, to be inductively sound, it needs to be strong and have all the premises be true. So we look at the premise. Has it indeed snowed in Canada in the last 10 years? Yeah. Canada's up there at the top end of North America. It snows there quite a bit. So if the premise is true, I have good reason to believe the conclusion. That makes it strong. And the premise is actually true. That, coupled with it being strong, makes it an inductively sound argument. Some people will say it's a cogent argument. Same thing. So if I have an inductive argument, I'm going to do two things. Ask, is it strong or weak? And if it's strong, ask, is it inductively sound? If it's a weak argument, it's automatically inductively unsound, because all inductively sound arguments need to be strong and have true premises. Once we get good at logic, we're probably going to be able to tell if the argument's strong or weak pretty easily. Usually where some of the interesting discussions and debate comes in is whether the premises are true or not. We'll see how that works as the class continues.